well for producing such a budget in such very difficult circumstances. And I'd also like to place on record my thanks to the almost 6,000 residents who actually helped shape this budget to make sure that social justice and fairness were at its heart. Since the Tories introduced austerity in 2010, we as a council have been forced to introduce just over a quarter of £1 billion in cuts. And this year, we're obliged to bring in another £61 million in cuts. Now, Councillor Gilchrist quoted John MacDonald, the Shadow Chancellor, before, and I'll also quote him, or I think Pat Hackett mentioned it before, because he recently said that the government is actually using local councils as a human shield to drive through its austerity cuts. And that's true, and it's also a disgrace. But it is ironic, Madam Mayor, and other people have mentioned it, what's happened in Northampton, a Tory-led council, which has now gone bust under this Tory government. But still, the Tory government ploughs on with their cruel, unfair and vicious austerity measures. But despite this, I am delighted that as a council we're able to find £20 million to invest in children's and family services, but again, with no help at all from this government. Now, if Amber Rudd, the Home Secretary, had bothered to spend 5 minutes popping into the leader's office when she was in the town hall recently, she might have learned some lessons about how the austerity measures from this government are actually affecting real people out in the country. Madam Mayor, pay freezes for public sector workers, changes to benefits, the cruel rollout of universal credit, rising prices for energy and utilities, fears about the NHS and so on. All these issues show that the needs of Wirral residents must be addressed by this council. And our loyal council staff under austerity have seen their numbers reduced, their workload increased and their pay frozen. And as a proud trade unionist myself, I'm delighted that we as a Labour council continue to work with the trade unions and are able to give them a much deserved 3% pay rise. And hopefully, Madam Mayor, at the same time, we'll be able to do that without having to resort to any compulsory redundancies. So I wish to place on record my sincere thanks to all council staff for the loyalty and the commitment they've shown over the last few years. Now, I recognise, Madam Mayor, that we need to do all we can to improve the Wirral environment and the economy, and the Wirral Growth Company is a major part of that thinking. It should bring jobs, new homes, real growth, prosperity to Wirral. This Tory government is starving councils like ours of funds, so we've got to think outside the box, we've got to find that money ourselves, and I think we've got to be imaginative, which is what this budget is. So it's on that basis, Madam Mayor, I give full support to this budget. Thank you.
Now, I'm going to call Councillor Chris Jones in a moment, and I've got Councillor Patrick, and I've got Councillor Norbury and Councillor Whittingham, and I've seen Councillor Falk standing, Councillor Dave Mitchell standing, and Councillor Phil Brightmore. Adam Sykes, I've got you. Is there anybody else who wants to come in on the debate? Okay. So, I've got Paul Doughty and Warren Ward. Yeah? Anybody else? Councillor Eddie Boat, yeah. Okay, so we'll plough on. Now I'm going to call Councillor Chris Jones. Thanks.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Can I congratulate Tom on his maiden speech? It was a really thoughtful and really well-directed. One of this Labour-led Council's priorities is to ensure that the most vulnerable people in Wirral are safe and protected, and that we tackle inequality. So it saddens me somewhat that the opposition have mainly been barking on about the parking charges. And I think it was Jenny who commented that the people would not be able to get out of their cars because they couldn't afford £2 to park. Sorry, Jenny, it doesn't wash with me. I think your priorities are wrong. And I think this budget is going to try and absolutely tackle some of the stuff that we need to. Due to completely inadequate funding of health and social care by this government, and the huge increase in demand that we all acknowledge, this council has been forced to charge all of our residents the social care precept, It isn't something that we would want to do, because we realise that the tax burden, just by paying council tax, is more than some people can actually afford. And we've even got a police commissioner now having to ask Merseyside residents to pay more just to keep police officers up to try and ensure safety for people. But this is life under a Tory government. People are struggling at the lower end of the scale while the rich get richer. While councils like ours struggle, while the richer councils in the south easily manage and haven't had their budget slashed in the way that we have. And I haven't heard the party opposite complain at all. They can't even be bothered to formulate an alternative budget because they can't. And they should be absolutely ashamed to just raise an objection. I don't think Councillor Lewis should accuse anybody else of hypocrisy. And I support this motion. Thank you, Madam Mayor.
Thank you, Councillor Jones. I'm now going to call Councillor Tony Norbury.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. I'd just like to congratulate Thomas on a fantastic maiden speech. Absolutely fantastic. I have noticed tented depression town type accommodation has started to pop up throughout our communities. Northampton Council, which is being administered by government commissioners, said they could no longer set budgets that will protect the most vulnerable in their communities. Welcome to Tory Liberal Britain. The political choice the Tories and the Liberals have chosen for us is austerity. Since 2010, austerity has led to our societies starting to look like a Charles Dickens novel written at the turn of the century, attacking the most vulnerable and attacking our trade unions, the voice of the most vulnerable. We are seeing a breakdown of our society led by a deep, unsustainable cut to our council services, driving our residents into deep poverty. We see growing sub-communities that are being driven into extreme poverty and homelessness by a sustained and targeted economic attack by the Tory supports and the Liberals on our most vulnerable. To support this sustained economic attack on the most vulnerable in our society, the Tories on their own by introducing universal credit, taking away hundreds of pounds per month from people living with disabilities, bullying people in. Excuse me. Bullying people into not appealing by removing their source of income, attacking young people and their families, forcing people into food banks while putting more pressure on cash-strapped councils like Wirral. They are also attacking our NHS in the same way by starving it of resources and restructuring it ready for the American healthcare system model, which their rich mates in the healthcare insurance industry waiting on the other side of the Atlantic for their payoff for the nice financial Tory party and their Brexit agenda. This again puts more financial pressure on councils who are struggling to protect the most vulnerable, like Wirral. Our council's position has been made unsustainable by the Tory and Liberal austerity, while corporate businesses get away with not paying their fair share of tax, and the rich get richer, and the most vulnerable are forced into a modern-day equivalent of the warehouse, food banks. We want dignity, not charity. We don't want food banks. Bear this in mind when you vote in the May elections. The Tories and the Liberals have driven this country and driven the most vulnerable into poverty. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Thank you, Councillor Watson, as well. I'd glad that my insult was about to deliver to you as well. Can I start by congratulating... Thank you. Can I start by congratulating Councillor Tom Osher on a very fine maiden speech? I think he's a man, he's a council grounded in his community and driven by his politics, and I'm really proud that he's in the Labour group and on the Wirral Council. There's been some great irony tonight in some of the speeches from the other side. I especially like Jerry Ellis on Tom Osher saying it was talking utter rubbish. Wonderful irony there. And something that Andrew Hodgson criticised Adrian Jones to say, he never has anything to say, but he'll say it anyway. Well, ditto to you, Andrew. I wonder if the Tory councillors might acknowledge that it is their government that is destroying the budget of Wirral. I wonder whether they will also acknowledge that this is not so much a budget, well, we know it's not a budget amendment, it's supposedly a budget objection, it felt like a budget whimper. This is really quite poor for a party supposedly born to rule. I thought you might be better at this type of stuff. I wonder if you got confused. I know it's 3 minutes for a speech, not 3 minutes to write your entire objection to the Labour budget. But I also thought that the Dems might learn a few lessons from lazily following their Tory mates. Your criticisms, both of you in fact, your lazy, recycled criticisms of Wirral View are displaying a complete lack of understanding. You raise your hand, Councillor. It display a complete lack of understanding actually of what Wirral View is intended to do. You would dismiss.
Please, quiet.
I have no time for this, people will be grateful. I've never heckled any of you, I'll mention that. But you dismiss Wirral View, which is attempting to get to information, crucial information, yes. So you believe everybody across the world.
Okay,
well,
we want to get through this. We've got quite a few more speakers. Please, Councillor Patrick, please, give him some space.
I don't think objections are hacking from any side. Sorry.
I'm now
waiting
for the debate.
Sorry, Councillor Blakely, you've had your opportunity to speak. Councillor Patrick.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. I wonder if that time will be added off. I would have donated it to the Tories to put a better objection in, but I won't. The Wirral View is designed to get out important information to all of the communities across the Wirral. And it just seems quite shameful that you would delete this and take that budget option away, and therefore leave the poorest across this borough in the dark. The poorest who need to know about the food banks that are opening up for them. They need to know about the community groups that can support them as they're trying to deal with the austerity programme launched by the Tories, supported by the Lib Dems, and certainly nothing from the Green over there. I mean, I think it's quite appalling that it's only Labour councillors standing up here speaking any sense. I wonder if the Tory budget was learning some lessons from their government and their Brexit negotiations, because they are bringing the damage on themselves. They're sticking their fingers in their ears, making all the demands, cherry-picking, objecting to everything, but they're doing none of the work. Councillor Lewis said that the people of Wirral could have had a say on the council tax increase. Well, actually, the people of Wirral have a say each and every year, except for the fourth one, when they will determine at the local elections who they want to lead them. And I don't think they'll be fooled. I don't think anybody would be fooled. From the budgets that have been put forward today, the objection, the supposed amendment there, and absolutely nothing at all from the Green councillor, the budget's put forward today, it's clear who's leading this borough, and I think it's clear who the people of Wirral will be voting for in May. I commend this budget.
And then I'm moving on to the second list then, and the first person to speak in that list will be Councillor Dave Mitchell. Okay, Councillor Whittingham.
Thank you very much. I'm starting to be a bit croaky, so I'll just open say that. Firstly, I'd like to congratulate Councillor Osher on his superb maiden speech brought all together, and I'm very proud of yourself. I would also like to pay tribute and thanks to our hardworking staff who are out all hours going bad weather. There's no roads, and they're making sure that our contractors are making sure that kept road moving during bad weather. Local governments are facing an abyss. The combination of cruel and relentless Tory austerity combined with an aging population is the recipe for disaster. Combined that with the increasing demand for children's social care, again driven by relentless austerity, then both local governments and society in general are facing a perfect storm, the outcome of which is quite frankly terrifying. This perfect storm is perhaps why, according to the LGUI and Municipal Journal, the state of the Government Finance Survey, just 0.83% of councils have full confidence about the sustainability of their government finance. We have already seen casualties of pain in Northamptonshire. Council taxpayers have been let down by the Tory administration they evicted, as this Tory council has run out of money. I also understand that despite the sweetheart deal by the last year, the Tory party council, that council too is facing a similar fate. Again, another failed Tory council. I will trust the Tory party to run a bath in the council. They know the price of everything and the value of money. We are consistently told that there is no money, but as well as sweetheart deals from the summit, there's always money to be found for the tax cuts for the wealthy, big business and the DUP, of course. Utterly corrupt, watching the country buckle under relentless austerity whilst looking after the rich. That's the Tory party for you, the nasty party.
Yes.
Despite Wirral being totally let down by the Tories, I'm proud to support this budget that not only finds money to invest in our infrastructure, such as street building, but also a budget that delivers a £20 million investment in our young people. I'm also proud that we found money to award our hard-working staff a 3% pay rise. In the first 6 years of Tory rule, supported by Lib Dems, public sector workers' pay rose by just 4%, while the cost of living soared by 22%. Every year, that's a pay cut, and every pay slip is a painful reminder for those struggling to get by and to afford the basics. I'd like to thank Councillor Hodgson for highlighting your government's failures in tackling the debt. As quite rightly said, it's all about choices. So when you pass on to the DUP, the wealthy, and so on, whilst the vulnerable of society don't creep under austerity. I'd say, bring on the general election, let's get a Labour government in. That's for the many and not the few. I've been there, I've been with the budget.
Councillor Dave Mitchell.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Congratulations to Tom on his maiden speech. I'd like to say, first thing, I didn't put my hand up when you were talking about what they'll do because it's informing the people out there. We received it 2 days after the consultation finished. So that's really informing the people. It's a waste of time, waste of money. The thing is, Madam Mayor, there's a lot of things that have been said today. And a lot of attacks on the Lib Dems, as always. I'll take that on my shoulders, I don't care. That's why I'm from Brunswick. One thing, three things that I would like to mention to Councillor Lewis. The triple lock to the pensions brought in by the Lib Dems, that's the reason they're getting the rises that they're talking about. Pupil premium was brought in by the Liberal Democrats. That's the one thing that's really working for the children in our schools today. We raised the tax threshold as well. Something that Gordon Brown thought was impossible to do. But he did bring in the Gershon savings of 7% year on year for 3 years. I'm sorry guys, you forgot all about that, didn't you? That was over a quarter of the local authority spending when they were in power. That's, you do forget it, I'm afraid, you know? I did listen to the points that have been raised, and we did raise the points in relation to car parking. It's been mentioned twice. The one thing was there was an excellent piece of work done by all parties on this authority on residence parking. It cannot refuse to accept the decisions that were made by other parties, and maybe first part of that issue. So there are things that they can do, and they should be doing. We know it's political, it's all political to be that way. Things that happened locally, as I said before, we had Gershon savings, and other things are hitting us now, which came out in the past. And that's PFI, we've got closed school down here, which we're going to be paying for. And the same thing with that. The one thing we're always saying, the NHS is struggling, it's really struggling, because the PFI that was brought in and all the development had taken place. Government after government, since then, they've put extra money in to the NHS. The one thing is, a top slice of that goes off to pay PFIs. It doesn't go anywhere near to the NHS. Thank you, Madam.
Thank you, Councillor.
Your
Councillor Fox.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. I had to make a contribution because we just had a great speech from my great nephew, Tom O'Shea. Congratulations. Mum and Dad would be proud, and Barbara and Roy will be up and down on his mate and say, well done, sir. I also want to make a little mention of a lovely lady in our ward, our branch secretary and deputy branch secretary. And I do this on behalf of all politicians because without people doing the mundane jobs of politics, like secretaries work. A great lady, Anne McNeil from Claude Ward, has passed away in her funeral on Friday. And I'd say this on behalf of all parties, we have these people who doggedly work for us, and without them, democracy would fall apart. So I take credit. Tribute to Stuart, because he gets a battering here every time we have a full council. You all queue up to say what's going on, Mike, what's going wrong, and street lighting and all the other things that is a very difficult budget heading. But Stuart, as the political lead, we were winter ready, we delivered, and we kept working. So welcome to you. I almost bore when I hear the Lib Dems talk. The Lib Dems have got selective amnesia, a period of their life that never existed, when they were partners in government with Cameron, when they delivered the bedroom tax, when they delivered an austerity programme, and of all the parties, who I thought would have stood up for local government where it mattered, they let us down, and that's why we're in the position we're in now. They let us down, and they've got blood on their hands, so don't ever, anyone in this chamber, forget the Lib Dems contribution to our downfall. It's there, and it's a matter of history. I'd just like to say, I'm so proud of this budget, because I, like many other Labour Party members, came into the budget setting process, and I can see frontline services being really under threat. We've managed to protect virtually all frontline services. We now hear from, councillors walking and saying we shouldn't put charges in car parking areas where people want to visit. I go all over the country, Southport, whatever, all the places, Lake District, Peak District, they all charge. And the reason they do that is because they're in the budgetary situation and they want to upkeep and maintain their resources. We've now found out why the West Cairn residents rejected residents' parking, because they're using the prom as a residents' parking area. That can't be right for one of our major tourist attractions, that it's now become nothing more than a car park for residents. Something's gone horribly, horribly and stupidly wrong. If that's all out of the massive cuts we've had to make, that's the only really objection we've got, I say well done to you, Leader. I say well done to the leadership team, and I say well done to this Labour Council.
Councillor Phil Brightmore.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. I'd just like to say first, I'm very proud of Tom. He's been going out trying and I think he's an excellent speech. Really well for him to be. I'm also very proud of this Labour group and the officers that helped it in producing this budget, which is fantastic. After years of continuous austerity, I'm astonished to find we still managed to protect frontline services. I genuinely think that producing the budget is the chief political aim, the chief political duty of any group. Yeah. I think it's the chief political duty of any opposition to produce an alternative budget. I genuinely presume Councillor Lewis came to the conclusion that they're going to read it, and they probably wouldn't, Councillor Lewis, but you still got to produce one. It's by everybody to produce one. That's how this works.
It's the only one thing you've ever taken for myself.
Thank you. This is not a conversation exchange across the chamber. Councillor Brightmore, carry on, please.
These are public documents, and the public, if they so choose, I don't suspect many do choose, may review them. I worry about if anyone wants to exercise that right, looking at the many detailed pages from Labour, fewer from Lib Dems, but brave effort, and barely half a page from Conservatives, they come to only one conclusion, and that's that you treat your elected duties with utter contempt. Now, I know that most of you don't. I hope none of you do, but that would be the impression. I hope they're not right. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Adam Sykes.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. First, I'd like to congratulate Tom Shell on his maiden speech. It was a great speech, even if I didn't agree with the content. Madam Mayor, I would like to personally welcome the pay increase for staff, which is well deserved for all their hard work they've put in during some very hard times. It's a shame that the 1.4 million for chief officers and the 2.6 million on consultants couldn't have been more fairly distributed for low paid staff before now. Madam Mayor, we are now a couple of years into the 4-year plan that the leader of the council signed up to with the government. And anyone can see that the current situation is a very difficult one for the local government unless wearing very rose-tinted glasses. Transforming the way that services are delivered by councils is not just about getting rid of services, but about redesigning them so that they may be suitable for the 21st century, and hopefully the capital receipts are being invested wisely in reforms that under the Conservative government's extension of the flexibility of using these for transformation, hopefully we'll see some actual improvements. Madam Mayor,